Hello everyone, welcome to the video series on interesting topics of modern Python programming, and today we are going to talk about a module called queue. Okay, and using this module we can create FIFO queues, LIFO queues as well as priority queues. I will read something from the official Python documentation. It is written that it's a synchronized queue class. The queue module implements multi-producer, multi-consumer queues. It is especially useful in threaded programming. In threaded programming, when information must be exchanged safely between multiple threads. So it is officially written in Python documentation that this is a thread safe queue and we can use it while exchanging data between multiple threads. Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about queue. And if you do not specify anything and by default use the queue, it is a FIFO queue, first in first out queue. So to use this, we need to import the queue module and create the instance of queue. I know I am talking queue multiple times, but this is not my fault. So queue.queue, by default, I have created a FIFO queue. Now, just like any queue data structure, we need to put data in the queue and get data from the queue. So put data in the queue, I will use put function. So in this particular for loop, I am putting 5 items in the queue. And I can get the items from the queue. The beauty of get is that once you get an item, it is removed from the queue. And I can check it using a while loop till the queue is not empty. I can get the values from the queue. Now, in this particular get, you can see that it is FIFO. What I inserted here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. What I get, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Whatever I have inserted first, I will get that first. And I can get the size of the queue by, you know, calling a function called queue size. Okay, the size is currently 0. Why? Because I have removed everything from the queue. I have called the get function. And if I go ahead and call this, you know, put the values again in the queue once. Yeah, and if I go ahead and check the size, it will be 5. Okay, now when you go ahead and create the queue, the size is infinite. Okay, but we can, you know, specify the size of the queue. And you know, most of the time in your programming world, in your production world, you would like to use the size. And we can create the queue with the predefined size by calling queue with a parameter called max size. So in this particular case, I am creating a queue of size 5. Now, why I'm creating the queue of size 5? So that I can show you the get and put function. What will happen if it reaches to the maximum size? How can we put the data? Or if there are no data, how can we get the data? Or what will happen if we call get or put, which is, you know, beyond their size limitations? Okay, so let me first create a queue with max size 5. And I can check the size by calling a member max size. Okay, now by default, the queue get function, okay, it is a blocking call. If there is no data in the get, it is gonna wait forever till the data is made available to the queue. Now, to demonstrate this particular behavior, I will create a queue in a separate thread and I will call the get function from that particular thread so that you can understand what I'm trying to say. So I have already created a video series on multi-threading in Python. If you are not aware of threading, please go ahead and look into that particular series. So I am importing threading and I am creating a function getInThreads where I am printing thread started and what is the value coming out of get. Okay, so if I go ahead and create the thread and start the thread, you can see that thread started is printed, but not the thread gets the value because queue.get is waiting for a value to be made available in the queue. And if I just go ahead and put 100 in the queue, this particular line gets called, the thread gets the value is equal to 100. Okay, so it is a blocking call. It will wait till any item is available in the queue. Okay, similarly, there is a non-blocking way of calling get. But what will happen if there is no data and we are calling get? We will get an exception and we need to catch that exception, and that exception is queue.empty. So I have again created a function with queue.get block equal to false. I do not want it to be blocked and I am catching the exception. And if I go ahead and start the thread, it will say that, you know, empty queue exception raised. If I go ahead and put some values and then restart the thread again, we will get that value. Okay. So regarding put, just like get, by default put is also in the blocking mode. If there is no size available, no empty slot available with the put, it is gonna wait for it to be available. Okay. So let's put 5 elements, because the size is 5, and if I check if the queue is full, yes, queue is full. Okay. Now if I say block equal to false, a new exception will be raised, which is called queue.full, and I have created this function to check that. And if I go ahead and call this function, you can see queue is full, is being raised. If we do not explicitly call block is equal to false, it is by default true, which means it is going to wait till the space is available to put some data in the queue. Okay. Now for both get and put, we can specify a timeout. Of course, we know this is blocking, but we can specify a timeout. So in this particular case, I am putting timeout of 2 seconds with put. So what will happen if I go ahead and try to add some data? Let's wait for 1-2 seconds. It should say queue is full. Okay. Same thing, similar thing can be done for get. In here, I am trying to get something, and blocking is true, which is by default true, which you don't need to make it explicit, and timeout as 2 seconds. Let me first empty the queue. Okay, we have emptied the queue. Queue.empty is true. And if I call this function 1-2 seconds, it is saying queue is empty. Okay, so this is all about queue and the functions of queue and how you can use it. Let's talk about LIFO queues. Last in, first out. Okay. So to create a LIFO queue, you need to create the instance of a separate class called LIFO queue. And in here also, you can give max size. Okay. Max size equal to whatever number you want. And the same behavior of get and put, which we have just discussed, will be valid over here. Okay. So here is my LIFO queue. I am putting some value 1 to 10. And when I'm going to fetch that value using get, look what I am getting. I am getting in a reverse order. So 9 was the last element to be inserted, but first to be, you know, removed from the queue. Now let's talk about priority queue. It is by default store elements in the sorted order. So to create a priority queue, you need to use a class priority queue. Okay. And create an instance of this. Here also you can see max size. Okay. And all the behavior of get and put, whatever we have discussed earlier, will work over here. So in here, I'm putting some random values 10, 3, 17, and let's retrieve it. And we get things in the sorted order. And this is what priority queue is. But one important thing about priority queue, how it manages the priority, it uses something called min heap queue algorithm. And it is actually a kind of binary search tree, which means that any put will cost you logarithmic complexity. Okay, it will be a logarithmic complexity, not a constant complexity. Now I know what is the question that might be coming to your mind. If I want to use my own data structure and sort it, how I can use priority queue? Well, this is a topic for a separate video where I'll talk about how you can make use of, you know, heap queue algorithm. Okay, so that's all about normal FIFO, LIFO and priority queue. There is another thing called simple queue, about which we are going to talk about in next video. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.